we continue our discussion about the 2022 elections. And joining us this morning, we have the Secretary General of Hugpong ng Pagbabago, the party of Presidential Daughter Sara Duterte. We have former Davao del Norte Governor Anthony Del Rosario. Do I call you, well, former Governor Del Rosario? Welcome to Head Start.
Thank you, Karen, and good morning to all your televiewers. Anthony lang po, Anthony lang po.
Okay, but you are the official spokesperson of HNP.
Well, actually, I was in our last meeting last month. Mayor Sara asked me to be the spokesperson for HNP. And of course, I accepted, but we just have to wait for the official announcement. Kasi ayoko naman pangunahan si ma'am
when it comes okay. to All right, so let's start first with Gibo Teodoro's visit for his second vaccination. There were interviews conducted by the media there, but has it firmed up the possibility of a Sara-Gibo tandem for 2022?
Well, actually, anything is possible at this point, ma'am. No? You know, the mayor, Mayor Sara, has not really decided yet, first of all, whether or not she's going to run. And secondly, she has not also discussed with the group with regards to her choice for vice president. We've already heard Mr. Teodoro stating that he is willing to be the vice president of Mayor Sara if she decides to run for president. And we also heard that from, I believe, Congressman Romualdez saying the same thing. But again, to this date, there is no final decision yet as to who will be the vice president.
Okay, there are also posters or memes, as they call it, on social media, asking for a poll of a Sara and Amy Marcos tandem. Is that a possibility too?
Well, anything at this point.
Is Sara even entertaining that?
Well, you know, at this point, these are all friends of Mayor Sara. No? Martin is a friend, Du Bois is a friend. Of course, Amy is a good friend also. So anything really is possible at this point. No? As a matter of fact, I'm sure in the next few months, you'll probably even hear other possible vice presidential candidates. So I guess at this point, we're really waiting to see as to what is the decision when it comes to the presidency before we can move on and discuss about the vice presidential candidate.
Okay. My sources over the weekend tell me that President Duterte is running for vice president under PDP Laban. It seems clearer now, well, based on my sources, no? So will this be either an obstruction, a condition, a problem for Mayor Sara to make her decision? In other words, if President Duterte runs for VP, will she still run for president under HNP? We'll talk about the party later because it's a regional party. So she has to be carried by a national party. But would her father's running for vice president be a factor in her decision making?
Well, I believe so, ma'am. No? Because I think everybody knows that the mayor has already mentioned that a Duterte-Duterte tandem is not really something that she's interested in. So if it is really the case wherein President Digong will run for vice president in 2022, then in all likelihood, you will probably see another presidential candidate aligned with President Digong for 2022.
Oh, no, pero clearly yun, kasi Mayor Sara already said that she will not join PDP Laban. Ang tanong ko is, she doesn't have to be the standard bearer of PDP Laban, but if her father runs, would she still run for the presidency even under a different party? Let's say Lakas HNP or any other party for that matter. Would she still run?
I don't believe so, ma'am. Again, it doesn't really depend on the party. No? It's just the whole principle behind it.
Parang ayaw niyang panalo na baka sila pandalawa ang panalo.
Oo, kasi may problema tayo sa check and balance na, ma'am. The mayor is very aware of that. No? And I believe, again, as she mentioned earlier, weeks ago, that at Duterte-Duterte tandem is not really something that she's in favor of.
Mm-mm. Okay. If the president runs for VP and he chooses Senator Bongo as the standard bearer of PDP Laban, this is a hypothetical situation. Would Mayor Sara allow that?
I don't see why not. No, if that is if Mayor Sara is no longer interested to run for president because her father is running for vice president, then anything could be possible. No? So if it, in this particular instance, if Senator Bongo is to be chosen as the standard bearer of PDP and President Digong will be the vice presidential candidate, then I don't see why Mayor Sara would oppose that particular candidate.
But let's be honest, if Senator Bongo is the partner of President Duterte, if the president chooses to run for VP, will Sara support another candidate for the presidency? Because sources tell me also of their relationship. And I'm curious if Mayor Sara will make her voice heard and support another candidate for the presidency.
Well, I believe, ma'am, I still believe that the Mayor Sara would still support whoever her father endorses. If this particular instance.
So you mean to say if Senator Bongo is the candidate, she would even campaign for him?
I believe so, ma'am. Really? Because if that is the candidate of the president, then I believe that the mayor will probably support whoever the president endorses.
Okay. And you have information on this, or this is just your personal belief?
This is my personal belief, ma'am. This is again, I know Mayor Sara, and I know the relationship that she has with her father, and she respects her father. And I believe that if her father says that that Senator Bongo is the standard bearer, then I think Mayor Sara will support.
So you believe Mayor Sara will support Senator Bongo?
Yes, ma'am. I believe so.
Okay. All right. On another note, let's go to the backgrounder first of HNP, because now HNP is getting into the national landscape. The reason why HNP was first formed, actually, it was formed actually to be a vehicle for a national run, but not for the presidency. It was meant to support senatorial candidates.
Well, actually, ma'am, in 2018, when we first met with Mayor Sara together with the other governors of Davao Region, the primary objective really of HNP, or the creation of HNP at the time, was really for the region. We initially saw in past administrations, there was divergence in the development of the region. And we thought, considering that in 2018, all the governors, or most of the governors and Mayor Sara were good friends, we thought to ourselves, maybe this is the best time to put up a regional party so that all of us can be together in unison in coming up with a development plan for the entire region. And that's really the reason why we came up with that party. No? And of course, in 2019, there was an election. And that was when Mayor Sara called us and said, we need to support President Digong and make sure that the senators after the 2019 election would be supportive of his legislative agenda. And that's why we shifted gears from being regional in view, and then we shifted to national for that specific purpose of ensuring that the legislative agenda of the president would be successful prior to the end of his term.
Okay, can HNP pivot as a party for Sara's presidential run if she chooses? Will you register HNP from provincial or regional to national?
No, ma'am. We've already decided that HNP would stay on as a regional party. And besides, we already missed the deadline. No? It's 1 year before the election, so we're already in July. Okay. So even if we wanted, talagang hindi ko pwede.
Uh-oh. And what about the Lakas CMD Alliance? House Majority Leader Martin Romualdez said he wrote, of course, formally for this. What is the status with this alliance now?
Well, right now, ma'am, it's still on hold. No, it's not only Lakas. We have actually five additional parties already signified.
Ano yung mga parties, sir?
I guess I'll tell you. It's Lakas, NUP, Nacionalista, NP, PMP, and PRP. No? Mm-hmm. So those are the five parties that have signified their interest to join this so-called coalition that we're building. But for the moment, everything is on hold because, you know, there has to be a memorandum of agreement between and among all parties. And currently, each party is reviewing the document, and we're still trying to come up with an agreement that is acceptable to all parties.
Okay. And would Mayor Sara, of course, she would, I'm assuming, have the last say, but what are the conditions for aligning with certain parties?
Well, again, this is still a draft, ma'am, so it hasn't been finalized yet. But definitely of significance are the provisions wherein HNP will choose the presidential candidate, HNP will choose the vice presidential candidate, and of course, HNP will come up with the 12 senatorial lineup for 2022. Mm. So yun ang mga important provisions na pinag-uusapan ngayon, ma'am, between the parties. So if we are able to come up with an agreement that is common among all the members or all the parties, then we will proceed with the signing.
Okay. Another question is, with what is happening inside PDP Laban today, are there PDP Laban members who have signified interest, frankly, to move to HNP?
Well, first of all, Bob, I'm not privy as to the goings-on in PDP, no? And I have not spoken to any particular member of PDP. And lastly, ma'am, any person who wants to join HNP has to be a registered voter of Davao Region. So if you're not a registered voter of Davao Region, then you cannot join. You cannot join HNP. So with regards to that particular question, I don't think it's possible that anybody from outside Davao Region can join HNP.
Oh, I mean, I know the deadline is passed over, but I'm curious, why do you think did Mayor Sara want to retain HNP as a regional party when, given her status, it could have been a national party that could have been very formidable?
Well, simply put, ma'am, she was not interested to run for president. When we talked about it last year, because we were already thinking about this deadline, no? And we were thinking, why not convert HNP from regional to national? And her response was, why do that if I'm not interested to run for president? Mm-mm. And so we said, hey, okay, fine. If you're not interested, then we leave it as such, no? as a regional party. This was a discussion we had last year. Mm-hmm. I can't remember exactly. I think it was about around same time this year also. So that's why we never bothered to convert it to a national party.
Do you believe that President Duterte, would you consider him an asset or frankly baggage to Mayor Sara running?
Well, I think not only Mayor Sara, no? I think every presidential candidate, well, I think most of them who believe in the president, believe also that he would definitely be an asset. As we have seen in recent surveys, he remains to be very popular with the people. And anybody who has that kind of popularity is definitely an asset going into next year's elections.
Mm-mm. Okay, what is the difference you feel? Because you do also have some sectors fearing that another Duterte, but would Mayor Sara be very different from her father?
Well, I've worked with both the president and with Mayor Sara. And definitely there is a distinct difference between between the two of them in terms of management, in terms of style of management. And
What is the difference in their leadership styles?
Well, you know, see, Mayor Sara is more development oriented, while peace and order is an important aspect in governance for Mayor Sara. I think she puts a lot of weight on development plans as well. Number two, Mayor Sara. How do you say it? Mayor Sara is, I think, very decisive. When she makes a decision, it's not a decision that changes over time. She sticks with her decision. And I think that's very important for a good leader to ensure that whatever she decides today will remain the same going forward. Mm-hmm. So I think those are really the things that make her different from her father. She's also very serious when it comes to work, very smart person. And she's done so much for Davao City. I think everybody in Davao City knows that the style of leadership between father and daughter are totally different. We have already seen cases wherein Mayor Sara has overridden the president has done in Davao City. Case in point, before the president assumed the presidency in 2016, as mayor, he signed a multi-billion project in Davao City. And then when Mayor Sara came in, within 6 months, na-cancel po yung multi-billion project. Mm-hmm. So iba talaga ang thinking ni ma'am compared to mm-hmm. President.
Okay. If Mayor Sara decides to run, who would you consider is her biggest or most threatening opponent?
Well, you know, the surveys will show, of course, that the good mayor from Manila is a strong contender. Of course, andyan din po yung ating vice president as a possible contender. You know, at this point, ma'am, everybody is a threat. No? If you were to ask me which one to choose, I can't really choose which one in particular kasi lahat po sila, they're all threats as far as we are concerned.
Mm-mm. But then there's Senator Manny Pacquiao, whom, if he decides to run, can potentially divide the votes in Mindanao and the Visayas, which is the base also of Mayor Sara.
Well, yes, definitely Senator Pacquiao's... if Senator Pacquiao decides to run, definitely that will affect the votes specifically in Mindanao. But again, we've already seen some surveys from Mindanao where most of the people in Mindanao favor Mayor Sara over Senator Pacquiao. So yes, it could divide the votes, but I don't think it would be that significant. And hopefully we'll be able to gain it in Luzon in next year's election. So hopefully that will be the
All
case.
Right. When will Mayor Sara make a decision? It's we're now entering July. And of course, you'd have to file in October. So we're talking about at least a solid 3 months.
Yes. Well, last time we talked, she's not. She basically said, "Let's see what happens in October."
Okay.
So, having said that, I believe that we will only know when the filing.
But then, isn't that a bit last minute? If we see what happens in October, you have to remember you're also going to choose a vice presidential candidate. You'd also have to field a complete slate of senators.
Yes.
Right.
Well, and actually,
you wouldn't want to adapt. You would want solid HNP plus alliance senators, yes. For example, and the locals. Yes. So it takes a lot of work. It's not just let's see in October.
Yes. Well, actually, after that discussion, when she mentioned that she would decide by October, we governors in HNP have suggested to her to come up with a decision before the end of July, by July 30.
Okay, all right.
So it's a suggestion, but it's not really a deadline because mm-mm. we want to give Mayor Sara all the time that she needs mm-mm. to really mm-mm. discern whether or not she wants to run. We don't want to pressure her into deciding.
Okay, no, that's very interesting. And I understand clearly, none of you want to pressure her. But clearly after Mayor Sara makes a decision, the real work comes in, right?
Yes, sir.
That's
yes.
when the real work comes in. Fielding the locals, fielding the senatorial slate. You have a congressional slate in every country na to. Hindi na to in Davao alone.
Yes, sir.
Oo.
Correct.
Oh, and how would you choose that? I'm curious because bigger parties like PDP Laban, well, I don't know if it will be followed, but the bylaw state that there should be a national convention, there's a voting system. But how would this one go? Would Mayor Sara choose personally, or would you have a convention and there's a voting system of some kind?
Well,
into the national sphere.
Yes, ma'am. With regards to the local candidates outside Davao region, definitely each party in the coalition will have to come up with their own lineup in the governors, congressmen, mayors, and so on down the line. But when it comes to the national candidates, as mentioned, if the parties agree, then HNP will be deciding on who will be the presidential candidate, vice presidential candidate.
And the Senate.
And so far as the,
the Senate.
As far as the Senate, yes, ma'am. As a Senate, po, of course, each party will be asked to submit a list of names that they would like to be included in the senatorial lineup. And then HNP will come up with the final decision with regards to the 12. But as far as the local candidates, ma'am, kanya-kanya po yan. Lakas will have their own candidates. MP will have their own candidates and so on and so forth.
And do you have an idea so far, at least initial discussions with the mayor, on how would she choose senatorial candidates other than winnability, other than, let's say, name recall? I mean, these are basics. But would she only choose, let's say, candidates that are aligned with her father? Or are we going to see a different Mayor Sara? Because she said if she runs, she would like to unite, right? The nation.
Yes.
Will
yes.
there be exciting candidates na magugulat ang tao na, wow, pinili ni Mayor Sara yun? Eh, di ba, medyo critical yun noon? May ganon?
Yes, yes. Well, as far as the agreement is concerned, each national party is allowed to submit at least one senatorial candidate. No?
Okay.
So, of course, once... Opo. So, right now, we have five national parties. So, theoretically, if you divide it equally among the five, it's about two or three senatorial candidates. No? Definitely, all of these things will be discussed with regards to... Definitely, winnability is a major factor in choosing candidate for the senatorial lineup. But definitely, depende po kay ma'am yun, no? Like for example, in the last elections, meron siyang mga dinala sa campaign who were not really that popular, no? because of their work that they've been doing, because of the way the thinking of that particular candidate, the mayor decided to bring them in, no? So it's possible also that could happen in next year's election.
Mm-mm. All right. On that note, is there anything you'd like to add, Anthony, before we go?
No, wala na, ma'am. Thank you so much for the time.
All right. And thank you also. At least now we know when we need to speak with HNP, you are the guy. You are the official spokesperson. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul.
All right.